get a £5 free bet every week with Offer Club from William Hill. Simply stake a total of £20 or more across the week on pre-match football accumulators with four or more selections, and you'll get a £5 free bet on the Friday. Join William Hill Offer Club on mobile or online now.
Fighting on November 5th on the undercard, it's a cool feature to Manny Pacquiao versus Jesse Vargas. This is the very first time that you're fighting on a Pacquiao card. How excited are you about this?
I'm very excited. You know, not only that, everybody has a gift to watch both of us at the same time, you know, in the same card, which is incredible. But just being in that atmosphere of legends gives me just a great honor, man. I'm very excited.
Now, you will be taking on a very hungry lion in Jesse Magdaleno. However, you're the dragon in this scenario here.
I eat lions for breakfast, man. I don't care how starving the lion is. You know, I'll be ready. You know, and that's pretty much what this outcome is in my head. It's just the outcome of victory. Regardless what he does, what he gives me, I'm ready for it. I am unstoppable in my head, in my mind, and I train out there with that mentality. You know, regardless how hungry it is. I mean, I've been there. I know how it is. And I've been to a point where the target has always been in my back since 2007. You know, and I've taken everybody who comes in front of that ring. You know, the majority of the times, you know, I'm successful. But from this moment on, that's what the story is going to be. Success for every fight.
Now, let's talk about experience versus youth. The champion versus the challenger. Do you still have that desire? Because let's not forget, you were once that challenger when you took on a heavy hitter by the name of Victor Chinian. Do you see a little bit of yourself in the opponent that you'll be facing on November 5th?
I mean, I can relate to where he is, but for me, really, the desire is there for me. You know, that's where I focus. I don't focus on what he does or what he's good at or whatever. It's just doesn't make sense. Why focus on somebody's strength when you can focus on yours? So that's where I'm at, is focusing on my strength, focusing on my training, and knowing and confidently and have the certainty that I'm victorious on November 5.
You know, a lot of fight fans might be more excited about this co-feature more than the main event. I know I am, because you got a guy who's undefeated. He's 23-0 with 17 knockouts. As I mentioned before, he's a hungry guy. You still want the fight. You still want the title. I mean, are you going to steal the show?
Well, I don't look into stealing the show or anything like that. I don't have that mindset. I just go out there with the mindset of victory, the mindset of knocking this kid out. That's pretty much it. Easy as that. I don't, you know, the more that I put into it, the simpler the mindset is, the better for me to go out there with a clear mind and certainty that victory is at hand. You know, the more that you put into this, the more that you start to get all frazzled and nervous and all that stuff, just one set, one mindset, that is victory.
Now, if you do defend your title on November 5th, would you consider moving back up to 126 pounds and possibly taking on WBO featherweight champ Oscar Valdez?
Well, the thing is, 26 pounds is something that I want to go up to. But right now, I know that I'm small. I mean, I'm walking around at 129, 130. You know,
that
pretty much exactly. So when I fought Walters, the day of the fight, I was at 129. So that in itself is a disadvantage for me, especially for hungry fighters who are incredibly talented, you know. But that, just the challenge riles me up, man. Ah, I love fighting. I love fighting the good fighters, you know, the great fighters. That's what I live for. It's like those guys jumping off buildings or skydiving. You just live for that thrill of fighting a good fighter or a great fighter, you know. And that's why you'd probably see me at 126, because if the challenge at 122 is not something that pushes me, you'll find me at 126.
Do you feel that's what you needed, was a young guy who says he's coming in to knock you out, to take your title?
Yes. I'm again a dragon. Bring it on. Bring it on, hungry lion. You know, I love it, man. I love challenges again. Challenges is what drives me, because it makes me better. It makes me push myself harder. You know, and that's where I want to be, is to be able to motivate and inspire myself to train every day harder than the next. You know, harder the day before, and just the next coming after, just keep getting better and better. And I love that, because I haven't felt that way in a long time.
My last question. What do you think about Vasily Lomachenko versus Nicholas Walters? Who's taking that fight?
incredible fight, man. That's a very, very interesting fight. I mean, again, both fighters are different, you know, in terms of styles, comparable to Hearns and Sugar Leonard's. You know, straight right hand down the middle is usually the killer for southpaws, but is the southpaw enough lateral movement that he can get away from all of that? So that's the question, but it's going to be an incredible fight.
I'm looking forward to November. I'm looking forward to your fight. Thank you, Nonito. Always a pleasure, my man.